Hey guys, and welcome to yet another video of Fragrance Jam, and this is actually going to be a very special video. And the reason why this is special is because this video contains two of my favorite things. First is Ajmal, because I love that brand. No matter what they sell, no matter how they sell, it is the best. And the second thing is Oud. I mean, I literally love that note. And I am kind of starting to hate the other perfumes, mostly designer perfumes, because I don't know, they don't impact me that much. So today I have five of the most potent perfumes by Ajmal, which are of course oud based, but they are different from each other. So I won't say that they are exactly the same. There are some things that make them different from each other, and we'll discuss what exactly is that. So I'll be honest, people who are into designer stuff might not like this perfumes. People who like designer perfumes like let's say Tom Ford, or let's say Dolce & Gabbana, or let's say Davidoff things, they might not like it. So please stop watching this video if you are not into these fragrances, or you can simply watch it and increase my watch hours. I really need it. This is a non-sequential video. That means that the series that I'm going with right now has nothing to do with the performance, potency, or price of the perfume. It is totally unrelated. So the first perfume that I'm going with right now is one of my favorite perfume from the house of Ajmal, and it is Ajmal Kalab. Now this is how the box looks like. I won't take much time to show you the box. It is very minimalistic box, you know, just a cardboard box and that's it. And this is the bottle. Very good, very minimalistic, and this is how an oud perfume should be. Now those of you who don't know about this perfume, this is an oud and rose based combo, and there are a lot of oud and rose based combo available in the market. Basically, my best perfume for this DNA, apart from this one, is Rasasi's Fakat Lil Rijal. I'll be honest with you, this is my most complimented oud perfume. I mean, there are other perfumes which are in this video, and whenever I apply those perfumes, people literally run away from me because they are that much potent and skanky. Like always, I do not care. I still wear them because I love them. So this is what Ajmal has. I mean, the bottle is very good. This is actually a 50 ml bottle, and trust me, 50 ml works very fine. This is very potent stuff, and I love this perfume. Let me waste a few sprays for you and tell you how exactly the notes are here. I mean, not all the people have access to Ajmal stores, and that is the reason a lot of people are doing blind buy of oud perfumes, and later they regret it. So at least this will help you to decide whether or not you should buy it. Awesome. I mean, this is actually my second bottle. I had one more bottle which I sold because I was getting a full bottle at a discounted rate. So I got this one and I sold the other bottle, which was almost half. I used half bottle, that means approximately 20 to 25 ml in 2 years. It is that much good. I'll be honest with you, I got a lot of compliment from this perfume. So if you are looking for an oud perfume which is a compliment getter, yet it might offend some people, but if you're okay with it, please go with this one, which is Ajmal Kalab, my favorite. Now again, the second perfume that I am going to talk about is an oud perfume, of course, and this is Ajmal 1001 Nights. So this is how the box looks like, and this is what you can expect in a box. Very simple, minimalistic, and normal cardboard box. The bottle, on the other hand, is a piece of art. I mean, just look at this bottle. It is like that chirag of Aladdin from where a genie emerges out. So this is what you'll get at first look. Now, this is actually a non-safer oud as compared to Kalab. This is, you know, a mature oud. So I'll recommend mature people to wear this one. Not all the people, again, will appreciate it. It literally feels like you are sniffing something old, something aged. And that is why this perfume is still in my collection. It is the best. At one point, I was thinking about selling it, but again, I kept it for myself, and I am happy that I did that. this is very good again. And if you are into aged ouds, this is what you can expect. The lasting is very good, about 6 to 7 hours in an air conditioned environment. In a normal environment, or let's say in summer, this won't last. Any oud, for your information, won't last in summer, because you know, oud is not meant to be for summers. So this is again 1001 nights, and if you're looking for slightly mature thing than Kallab itself, then you can go for this one, Ajmal 1001 nights. Now the next thing that I'll discuss here is an attar, which is literally so potent that the people at my home are fed up from last 4 to 5 days, because I am using that attar at home, because not all the people will appreciate these kind of things. And now I know that the people at my home are those people, sadly. So the attar that I am talking about is Dhanal Oud Khalifa. Yes, it is Dhanal Oud Khalifa, not any other Khalifa. Don't go there. This is how the presentation looks, and very good, very elegant. This comes around 5000 rupees, which is its MRP. But I will recommend you to get this perfume if and when there is any kind of sale at Ajmal, because I got this at a sale and I got this at a really good price. So this is how the presentation looks. The box opens like this, and this is what you can see inside the bottle. Now here the attar is fit very tightly. I mean, you need to apply a lot of pressure in order to remove this, and this is how it goes. This is what you can get in the bottle. Now just an FYI, this is a 3 ml bottle. Yes, just 3 ml of attar in this flacon, and that's what you get. But that is enough. I mean, I'm not applying it right now because I don't want to waste this one. However, I'll still remind myself how it smells, and this is amazing. This is literally amazing. This is what you can get in this 3 ml. It is very fine quality agarwood attar, and very straightforward, direct and raw. You cannot expect this to be a crowd pleaser. It was not made for pleasing other people. This perfume right here is for your satisfaction, so that you can get the whiffs of this quality whenever you are making any body movement after applying it. Your movement will trigger the scent, and you will start getting the whiffs of this. And yes, it leaves a very good scent trail whenever you have applied this one, and you are crossing someone and who are nearby, they will get the perfume that you're wearing. But trust me that they won't appreciate it. So if you are willing to take that risk for yourself, you can get this one. I know people who are into oud and people who appreciate ouds will get me, and people who are not into ouds, they won't get me. So Dhanal Oud Khalifa by Ajmal, just try it. At least go somewhere at Ajmal store and try this one, and if the discounts are good, grab it. Now the next attar, yes, one more attar. I don't usually prefer attars over perfumes, because you know, applying perfume is very easy, and you know, it does not take that much of your time. Prices were good, so that is the reason I got it. And trust me, I made an excellent choice, an excellent decision, because I do not regret it. So the next attar that I'm referring now is again the skankiest attar in my collection, and it is Dhanal Oud Rashid. Now this attar can actually be classified as a raw version of Dhanal Oud Khalifa, which we discussed just now. So when I compared these side by side, I actually saw that this is actually raw, and Dhanal Oud Khalifa is actually a more wearable version of oud. So what you get here is the same thing that you get in Dhanal Oud Khalifa, but this is actually skanky and more animalic. Now as per me, I actually prefer more animalic things and more skanky things, because I love them. So that is the reason I prefer this one more as compared to Dhanal Oud Khalifa. I really like that one, but I love this one. It is what it is. Again, it is man, this is strong and potent. So yes, this is a 3 milliliter bottle again, and it is hand carved. I mean, you will be able to see what kind of majestic bottle is this. Again, this is not for the people who are into designer stuffs. They won't appreciate it. And for the people, for the crowd who is, just into the perfumes which are sweet and safe, those people won't appreciate it either. But still get it if you are looking for a badass oud perfume which you can apply and just relax. If you're into perfumes which are direct, which are to the point and no fooling around, this is the thing that you can get. Now the next and last perfume that is in my collection is again my favorite one, and you know why it is my favorite one. If you have seen this video, you'll know. So again, this is none other than Daniel Oud Al Shams, and this is how the bottle looks like. I won't say that it is minimalistic bottle because it is created very nicely. The cap here is a very light cap, like it feels that it is a regal thing, you know, heavy stuff or something, but it is not heavy, it is very light. The bottle on the other hand is again a piece of art. This is what you can expect in this bottle. And the perfume, oh god, this is, let me waste a few sprays for you and remind myself how it actually smells like. And okay, just one spray is enough, and I can literally smell it here. Okay. So this is what you get here, a very skanky, animalistic, direct, raw and Banyardish oud. This is what you get. I mean, even if you mix these two oils and apply on one hand, and if you are applying this one on the other hand, this will be potent as compared to these two. It is that heavy. I mean, no doubt it is costly and it might not be available in India right now, but there are a few sellers who are selling this. People were talking a lot about Rasasi's Boru series. I gave them a try. I tried three of the perfumes. I was expecting them to be more Banyardish or to be more skanky or strong, but as usual, those perfumes were actually a crowd pleaser since they were designed in such a way that not all the people will get offended by it. Now this on the other hand is something that will set you apart from all the people who are wearing it. So this is it. This is the last perfume that we are going to discuss today. Do let me know in the comment section which one do you like from these perfumes. And I'm hunting down a lot of perfume which has oud in it. So, you know, my quest is to find a perfume which is the best in terms of oud. And till the time I'm not getting that perfume, I'll keep hunting. So do let me know in the comment section if you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe, and I will see you around in the next video. Take care.